I am gonna make a bold statement here, which is 99% of the productivity apps you have seen, you have used are absolutely trash and they are not worth your time. So the reason why that is a truth is because of the fact that productivity apps are probably the easiest apps to code and to design. But that doesn't mean that there are some of them that are just incredibly effective, and that's why I picked out the 8 productivity apps in 22 that are just incredible. So here is the list of best productivity apps in 2022 that are the most effective, the simplest to use, the best designs, and the most essentially useful ones. So let's get started with that list. So the number one app on our list, best productivity apps in 2022, Endel. And Endel essentially helps you focus a lot better when you're studying, when you're reading, when you're working out, or when you are doing anything else. Why? Because they provide you with different kind of like background noises that are scientifically proven to increase your focus. For example, let's say you are studying and then you turn on Endel and you put on that studying background kind of noise. It's not like a music, it's kind of like a sound. It's kind of like a combination between different tunes, and you don't really hear it much when you're focusing on your studies, but it is just incredibly effective to help you focus more. It helps you a lot when it comes to, for example, getting into that deep work focused like flow state, and that's one of the secrets I essentially use to get into that deep flow state every single morning. That's why it has to be on this list, best productivity apps in 2022. I just like it so much. Best productivity apps for 2022 is going to be Todoist. I used this app for nearly like 2 years when I started my personal development journey. This app is essentially a task management system. At the same time, it is a project management system where you basically put down your tasks on a daily basis, on a weekly basis, and check them out every single day or every single week, where you manage everything that you have in your life. It is incredibly effective and it is really easy to use. That's why I used that for like 2 years, to be honest. And of course, I actually had a list which is called To-Do. Like to-do list, easy. Write down things that are not really important, like things that I had to remember. This might be chores, this might be something that I had to buy. So I wrote those things off to this app that really helped me a lot when it comes to not forgetting small details and small things in my life. That's why Todoist, a great app to use. I use that a lot, to be honest. And the number 3 on our list, best productivity apps for 2022 is going to be essentially Google Calendar. And this is something you already knew, because Google Calendar is absolutely the best time blocking app that you can use, the best calendar out there probably. As you know, a lot of people you might be following on YouTube, like Matt Devella, like Thomas Frank, a lot of people are using this Google Calendar because it is incredibly effective. I use that a lot, to be honest myself, because the best way to manage your time is to block that time. That's why I do think that Google Calendar is absolutely the best calendar out there. I plan my days in like 2 ways. The first one is where I have essentially my meetings, important things, just like 1-2 things every day. And another one is like a general kind of schedule that I have, which kind of sometimes changes, but I don't do my changes on Google Calendar because like I don't want to play with that every single day. That's why like Google Calendar is just the one-on-one productivity app you should be using if you want to get your productivity to a next level. The 4th app in our list, best productivity apps for 2022, in 22, whatever that is essentially Freedom. And Freedom is an app that I learned from a good friend of mine, Dimitri, which essentially is kind of like a screen time limiter that you can use for different apps or different websites. So what it does is, for example, you are wasting a lot of time on YouTube, and you can use essentially this app Freedom to block that YouTube, because it is incredibly important for you to not spend a lot of time on these apps. As you know, I talk a lot about productivity. That's why limiting and not using a lot of technology throughout the day is just one thing that you should be focusing on. That's why the app Freedom actually is a pretty good choice out here. But to be honest, all our phones, smartphones, which is right here, actually already have a feature that is probably called in the iPhone screen time, and in Android, I'm an Android user, it is called, I think, digital well-being, where you can see how much you use your phone every day, how you can track it, and you can also set limits without using the app as well. The 5th best productivity app in 2022 is going to be essentially TickTick, also an app that I used for a really long time, just like Todoist. And the TickTick is essentially, by the way, it's TickTick, not TikTok. TickTick is basically a task management planner, kind of like a, it actually is a
stop it, get some help.
all in all productivity system, I can say. It has a habit tracker in it, it has a Pomodoro timer in it, it has a task management, it has a project management, it has literally everything that you are looking for, and I used TickTick for half a year to essentially design my whole life. I used to essentially put down all my tasks in TickTick, I used to track my habits in it, I used to use the Pomodoro timer when I was studying, so that's why TickTick is, in my personal opinion, one of the apps that you can use. And also, if you don't want to use like five different productivity apps at the same time, I do think that TickTick is going to be a pretty good option for you because it just has everything just in one app. The sixth app in our list, best productivity apps in 2022, is going to be essentially Forest. And as you guys also know, probably I talked about the app Forest a lot on my channel because it is just amazing. So let me explain you how it works. It is basically an app that you download on your phone or in your computer, doesn't matter. You start a study session or a work session, and while you're doing that, you are essentially growing a tree, and if you complete the study session successfully, then you have a tree. If you go on YouTube or if you go on Reddit or I don't know, whichever you want, then you lose that tree dies. That's why this app kind of keeps you motivated to study more, because at the end of the week, you will have kind of like a forest of couple of like trees that you have built throughout the days because you have been studying hard. Probably, hopefully. And the seventh productivity app out there in our list, best productivity apps in 2022, is going to be, of course, Notion. Notion is probably the king of productivity apps out there, the king of YouTube, because you probably have seen like hundreds of videos about it. You might have also used it yourself, but I'm not gonna be talking about Notion a lot because it is just something that everyone talked about a lot. If you want to learn more about that, just check it out on a lot of videos on YouTube. It is basically an all-in-all productivity app where you can literally manage anything you want. It's much more deeper than TickTick, which is already a deep app. That's why you can understand that Notion is something that you can do whatever you want in. The very last productivity app in our list, best productivity apps in 2022 that you can use that are completely free, are going to be essentially ClickUp. And ClickUp is also just like Notion, which is an all-in-all productivity app where you can do literally whatever you want. And when it comes to ClickUp, essentially there are a couple of like pretty popular guys on YouTube. They say that it is essentially better than Notion, and they are switching Notion to ClickUp. You can also check it out. I do think that it is something worthwhile to at least check it out. You can also do a lot of task management, project management, and you can literally do whatever you want on that app as well, just like Notion. So these are going to be essentially my top 8 picks when it comes to best and absolute like best productivity apps you can use in 2022. So thanks for watching, keep crushing it, and check this video out if you want to see more about my daily routine and how I keep myself productive 24/7. Yeah, I'll see you guys there.